at Watford Junction, Rugby and Crew. The 21:25 Irish Mail intercity service to Holyhead.
Whiskey, Irish, please.
You can tell him. That's the last.
Crew, Chester, Rill, Bangor, and Holyhead, connecting with the 0315 Sea Link sailing to Dunleary.
I knew he'd come back one day. Not to me, but to Ireland. I dreaded it. He always brought trouble. He wanted to change. Every time was the last time. There were so many last times. He couldn't change. Money. He was very good about that. Always made sure we had enough. I never touched it. I used it for the girls. I never took a penny for myself.
Thank you.
He came and went, like a thief. He took his shotgun. It was the last thing of his left in the house. And when I saw it gone, I thought, thanks be to God, it's finished. I've seen the last of him.
Mr. McNeil?
Hello, Joe. How's everything going?
Very well. One small problem. Nothing serious.
Good. I don't want to get hung up on this. I've got to be in Paris by Friday at the latest.
They're with us, Ryan Casey.
Everything set?
Saturday, at the airport,
as Father Cressy leaves for Paris.
Is that our only chance to hit him?
Yes. The special branch will have him hidden until then.
Thank God for Connor.
He says he's retired.
Retired? Doesn't he know you're still working for me?
Yes. But he said the London hit was his last one. He doesn't want to know anymore.
He's still living around here.
In the West.
I'll go talk to him.
He means it, Mr. McNeil. No more.
He'll do it for me, Joe. Two whiskeys, please.
Hello, John.
Hello,
It's been a while.
To old times.
Did your man contact you yet?
You've retired.
Right.
Now come off it, John. Men like us don't retire.
Don't they?
No, we stay in the action. We stay alive. You've been in the woods too long. Good for you to get back to work.
What do you use for money up here?
I have enough.
I'll pay you $40,000 for this. And you can enjoy yourself.
Don't need it.
Must be tough on that wife of yours, raising two kids on all her own like that.
She's all right. They're taken care of.
Look, one more job, and that's it. I need the best.
Get someone else.
You're the man.
Not anymore.
I saw Lewis a while back.
How's he doing?
Good. Eddie Kane got him a contract in South Yemen. All the action he can handle. He's still crazy. He'll never quit.
He can't.
The best men don't. The best men don't stop, John, especially not you. You more than any of us.
Take a couple of days, get yourself ready. Then come on over to Dublin. We'll go to work.
It's finished.
I got a commitment here, John.
Not mine.
I'd say it was.
How?
You forgotten it was me who pulled you off the skids after your wife kicked you out? If I hadn't put you back to work, you skidded your way all the way into the grave.
You needed me behind the gun. And I gave you value for money, for the best.
You owe me this one, John.
Mr. McNeil,
I don't want to see you again in this neighborhood where I live. I don't owe you a damn thing.
Are you sure?
Dear Daddy, we both send lots of love from America. We miss you and Mum very much.
The children loved him. He never got too close to them. He always kept his distance. He felt awkward when the girls were around. He never knew what to say to them. But he kept in touch. Whether that was love or guilt, who knows?
What do you think, then?
It's okay.
Any luck?
Like I said, Joe, he'll do it. Is Connor's family still around?
Well, the kids are in the States, but the wife's still here.
We'd better let our friend know about that.
Morning, Mrs. Connor.
Hello.
You, Casey. Afternoon, gentlemen.
Who are you? You all right?
I'm fine. How are you?
I have a message from the man.
What's the word?
Done.
What has to be done?
The job.
How is she?
She's all right at the moment.
What do I have to do?
See Mr. McNeil. He says it's urgent.
May I change?
Be our guest.
Anything you say. This mean?
That means you're here and you're gonna do the job.
The target and his escort will come out of this door here and walk to the aircraft. No more than 30 yards. That'll give us 15 seconds to hit him. The firing position will be in this warehouse here. The range is just over 600 yards. It'll have to be quite a shot.
What do you think?
He's right.
Can you do it?
Yes.
Good. Now, what about the rifle?
SLO 7.62.
Well?
No.
Why?
Not my weapon.
You've used it before.
Not at that range.
What do you want?
I'll use the old-fashioned one.
That's what I thought.
I'll need workshop facilities to tune it up and to fix a new scope.
For how long?
A couple of hours.
Okay, no problem.
The scope I want is a Site 6 power.
Right. I think we can get one. Good. Anything else?
Yes. When the scope is fitted, I'll have to zero it in open country.
Joe?
I don't like it.
There's no other way.
Well?
Okay.
Good. Now, the target. That's him, Father Cressy. What's on your mind?
Connor, he worries me.
Huh? He's 7 now.
Is he?
Look, I've known this man for a long time. He's good. We gave him a little bit of a push and he saw. Give him a couple of days to think on it. He'll come around.
Even so, I'll keep an eye on him.
All right.
Very hard to get.
Where are the mounts? Oh, just a minute. Thanks. Flynn, you move to your right. Please. A little more. Head a little bit. Pull it. Back a little.
Guns. All he ever knew was guns. His whole family were the same. His father before him. Why guns? History, maybe. But I don't think it was that. I think it was something deeper with Connor. He had this fascination. He was very gentle with them, though. In a way, he could have been a priest. I often said that.
Outer at 11 o'clock. Still the best.
How do you feel?
How do I look?
Lousy.
That's how I feel.
You're doing the right thing, John. Family life isn't for us. Now you get this job done, we'll talk again. There's plenty of action out there. Mm-hmm. You better get some rest.
Mr. McNeil, if you want to make that Paris flight, you better be off now. Ryan's waiting to take you to the airport. He has your ticket. Don't worry about Father Cressy. The job's as good as done.
Now the job in Africa. It's definitely a commando operation. I can put 40 men under Hogan. We'll create more havoc in that area, and those people will never know what hit them. The whole operation should take no more than 12 hours, including a dash to and from the coast.
If it means we can avoid getting involved with the National Army, fine. But my superiors will feel some disquiet about such a small force.
Remember, monsieur, we're talking about 40 of the most experienced professional soldiers on the European market.
The idea sounds good, but my superiors will need more details.
We'll make a complete plan.
How long will it take?
3 days.
Fine. We'll talk again later. Good night, Mr. Hogan.
Good night.
And what about Father Cressy, Mr. McNeil? Is everything going ahead in Dublin, as planned?
We'll hit him at the airport as he boards a plane.
Isn't that a little late?
It's the only chance we have. The Irish Special Branch has got him in a vice until then.
Mr. McNeil, if Cressy reaches France, this entire operation will be jeopardized. The department must not be connected with this in any way.
He'll never get here. The man making the hit is the best shot in Europe. Cressy will never make the plane.
I hope not, Mr. McNeil. For all our sakes. Good night.
Good night, sir.
think maybe he really did mean to give it up this time. The look on his face, you know, he'd have sooner died than go back to the old way.
Father Cressy, just a few minutes now. Ryan, you go up to the next floor and keep a lookout.
Sorry, Father, there isn't time for that. Father Cressy!
Ryan!
What's going on?
Find Casey. Get Connor.
I'll phone McNeil in Paris.
Well, we could take a leaf out of the Israeli book. Do an Entebbe?
Yeah?
It's Joe.
Hello, Joe.
The job. Connor crossed us.
What? How?
Never mind. We've still got to get Cressy.
All right, I'll organize something here. What about Connor?
I guess he'll make for his wife's place.
That's where he'd go. If Ryan calls in, tell him to bury him.
All the way?
All the way. In the meantime, stay by the phone. I'll call you later.
I'm in a payphone. Give me time to get to my place, then call me there, okay? And Mr. McNeil, Ryan and Casey are already on their way to deal with our friend.
Look, something's come up. We'll have to leave this for now. Contact the men that we agreed upon. I'll call you in a couple of days.
Sure. What happened?
The unexpected.
I had your assurance.
These things happen?
This is very awkward. As I said before, my people cannot risk being involved in any way.
We can take them here in Paris. I'm working on it now.
I'll have to get authority. Be here at 9 this evening. I'll give you instructions then.
Right.
Go now, if you want to be safe.
Will you never stop?
I have stopped.
How many times have I heard that?
Get a suitcase.
Keep the change.
Connor.
Where does this go?
To the railway yard.
Thank you very much. Bye now.
Tell Mr. McNeil that my wife is in a safe place, that if he wants to see me, he knows where to find me.
Did you get rid of Ryan's body? Good. Keep Casey hidden for a while.
When are you coming?
In a few days. I'm taking the slow way for safety.
The whole thing sounds like a setup.
No, it was a setup, all right. I'm sending someone over to take care of Connor.
You'll need the best.
The man I'm sending is the best. Look, I'll call you when I get in.
All right. I leave all the arrangements to you.
Okay, Joe. You get yourself to Ireland now, and take those guys with you.
All right. Better fix that wound first.
You never came up against Connor, did you? He's the best. You'll need those two good men. His place is in the middle of nowhere. Rugged countryside. Mountains, rocks, forests. He knows every inch of it like the back of his hand. And he'll be ready for you. Don't underestimate him. Connor will be playing the game he likes best. He's got all the advantages, except numbers. But he'll seem like an invisible army. Never where you expect him and always where you don't want him. If it ever gets out that Connor double-crossed me, I'm finished. So I'm relying on you, Hogan.
He's out there somewhere. Well, still 3-1 in our favor.
I thought I was buying the best.
Hey, those were two of the best men in the market. Against Connor, in that country, they didn't have a chance. He knows every rock on those hills.
I told you that.
You'd need a company to take him up there. Right. I'll fulfill the contract. I'll go back up, stake out the house. He'll come down eventually.
Joe. Make whatever travel arrangements he needs. Pay him off.
Right.
Mr. Devan rang. Meet him Dublin, the usual place.
I'm going now, Mr. McNeil.
You talk to anybody yet, Joe?
Tonight. He'll hear soon enough.
Good.
Too bad it went sour this time.
This is business.
Good luck, Mr. McNeil.
Bye, Joe.
Thank you.
Tommy.
Hello, John. Sit yourself down. What do you have? A large parmesan, that one. John, you know Rosie? Danny Byrne's sister.
Oh, Rosie, miss. How are you?
Fine, thanks, John. How are you?
I'm all right. How are you, sir? What's all this with McNeil, John?
I want to see him. I'd say he wants to see you. He was very easy to find. Listen, maybe you could do some backup.
I don't think so.
He mightn't come on his own.
What's a private matter, this? Where is he?
We better go now, Tommy. We don't want to be late.
That's all right. We have a few minutes. It's a big old house, way out in the country. What's the rush, John?
We'll have to be going, Tom. Thanks and good luck.
You take care.
Rosie.
Bye now, John.
He was single-minded and patient, so patient he could do the same thing for hours. But he had his moods, furious one minute, gentle the next. He never knew who he was or who he wanted to be. He was a wonderful dancer. That's how we met. It was a waltz, no, a foxtrot. He knew my name. He had this marvelous gaiety. After we got married, it all changed. People used to come for him, always at night, and he'd go away with them. He'd be gone for a day or a week or even longer. I never knew. And when he came back, he never spoke of it. As time went on, he never spoke of anything at all. He just cleaned his guns and waited. I used to look at him and say nothing.
I knew you wouldn't disappoint me. It's been easy so far, hasn't it, Connor? Dummy wire, Connor. Remember? Still at work in the Congo. The smoldering cigar. Best not to touch it, eh, Connor? Come on, Connor. Six rooms. Make your choice. Here? Could be here. Or there.
never brought me anything but sorrow.
The rain has eased off now, if you want to see the grave. It's round here, under the hill. Oh, a peaceful place.
That's where he belongs, in the mountains. Such a waste of a man. Thank you.